so much blood. So much death. So much betrayal.
The Irish Republican Army was a revolutionary military organization descended from the Irish Volunteers who staged the Easter Rising in April 1916. The Irish were fighting to establish home rule from the United Kingdom, which had been ruling over Ireland since the 17th century. They had long sought independence from the oppressive British, with a long and violent history of attempted insurgency. The violence carried out by the IRA stands as an early form of terrorism, in which they use the murder of public figures and bombings as scare tactics directed at the British forces. Their ultimate goal is regaled by the famous Gaelic slogan, Éireann go bra, Ireland forever.
We decided to take a stroll down to Bud's Metals shop, where we would find good all-American Bud Selig down there enjoying life. Now, Bud, how do you feel about the IRA? What impact have they had on your life?
Well, I've always had trouble reading in my time. I mean, I look at a book and I don't know what to think of it. I look at the words and it's all just jumbled.
I'm sorry, Bud, we're talking about the other IRA.
Oh, the Rifle Association. I love that one. I can't tell you how many of those meetings I've been to. I can't get enough of guns.
No, we're talking about the Irish Republican Army.
Oh, I haven't heard of that before. I've heard of the American Republic Army. We need more Republicans in America. More army and guns and beer and steak. I love steak.
Rising was an insurrection staged during Easter in 1916. The uprising was carried out with the goal of ending British rule and establishing an Irish Republic. However, after 7 days, the uprising was suppressed and its leaders were executed.
Move forward!
Michael Collins, who most would agree contributed greatly to the foundations of the modern Irish state, then took over as leader of the IRA, eventually leading the way to the establishment of an Irish free state guaranteed by the Anglo-Irish Treaty of 1922.
I'll sing you a song of our Elwyn the town. When the green flag went up and the crown flag came down, was the neatest and sweetest thing ever you saw. When they played that great game they called Éireann go bra.
And with Michael Collins leading the way, the Irish War of Independence began, standing as an early example of guerrilla warfare carried out by the IRA. It began in 1919 after the Irish Declaration of Independence, which was documented by the Dáil Éireann, a revolutionary Irish parliament. The IRA began to use violence and terror as a means of getting the Crown's attention.
Better Belfast efficiency is what they need.
Any of ye who've read Irish history will know that movements like ours have always been destroyed by paid spies and informers. And I want to set up an outfit that'll rectify that. Your job will be to wreck the system of information the castle uses against us. To make it unhealthy for them to run it.
Bloody Sunday is a notorious day of violence in which a string of murders carried out by the IRA took out members of the Cairo Gang, an undercover team of British agents working in Dublin.
Get away!
Lord, my shepherd.
Give us our country back. To live in. To grow in. To love.
Look, what?
The British quickly responded that afternoon when the Royal Irish Constabulary, or the British forces in Ireland, opened fire on the crowd at a Gaelic football match, killing 14 civilians. Eamon de Valera, or Dev, was the political head of Revolutionary Ireland. During the ceasefire of 1921, he sent Michael Collins to London to negotiate a treaty with the British.
I want to petition the American public for their support. I want recognition from President Wilson for an Irish Republic. I want the moral force of international opinion brought to bear on the British government.
If we are to negotiate as a legitimate government, our armed forces must act like a legitimate army.
Michael Collins returned to a celebrating Ireland with the Anglo-Irish Treaty, a document which established Ireland as a free state. However, disagreement arose over the terms of the treaty and the Dáil Éireann.
Look at the face on Smith.
Mr. Collins is asking us to accept an oath of allegiance to a foreign king and the partition of the northern part of the country. Mr. Collins, the man who won the recent war, has himself described the treaty as a stepping stone towards the ultimate freedom.
As a protest against the ratification of this treaty, which can only subvert the Republic, I and my deputies are going to leave this house.
Though the treaty passed, Eamon de Valera and those who agreed with him formed the anti-treaty forces, so beginning the Irish Civil War, in which those who agreed with the treaty fought against those who did not.
Do it!
Fire! Fire!
The Irish Nationalists, or pro-treaty forces, supported the establishment of a provisional government which governed Ireland in the transition period between the ratification of the Anglo-Irish Treaty. The anti-treaty forces thought the treaty betrayed the Irish Republic because an Irish free state meant that Ireland still had to take an oath of allegiance to the Queen. Though the pro-treaty forces eventually won the Civil War claimed more lives than did the Irish War of Independence on both sides. Michael Collins was assassinated soon after the pro-treaty forces won the Civil War. He was ambushed on a return journey to Dublin by rogue anti-treaty forces and died in a gun battle. He was the only casualty.
In 1968, the Provisional IRA split with the IRA, taking the lead in violent activities. After 30 years of low-intensity fighting, including the deaths of officers and civilians on both sides, voters accepted the Good Friday Peace Agreement. This made Ireland abandon their claim to North Ireland, but also granted North Ireland self-determination from the British. As of 2006, the IRA has been effectively disarmed and turned its back on violence.